Hello, welcome to the channel, Renzo here. I'm going to draw Paul Newman with charcoal. I have fine charcoal here, a pencil charcoal, some synthetic brown round brushes. Okay, a kneaded eraser here. First, I'm going to make a quick sketch. I'm gonna erase this sketch in a minute, but I need this to study the face to see the proportions. I'm gonna establish the top of the head, the bottom of the head, around here, the chin, here, the center line, the line for the eyes. Okay, this area is gonna be in shadow. Reflect the light here. Let me see the brows, from the brows to the nose to the chin. Okay. This simple sketch helps me to know about the face, the proportions, and to get a rough idea. Okay. Yeah, okay, that's enough. Now I'm going to make all this area dark. Now I'm gonna use my kneaded eraser and I'm going to erase the areas where I see the light and the reflected light. Okay. Do this. Let me see, have the, let's say the brow here, nose and chin. Okay. Now to do this, I'm squinting down my eyes. Yeah, because what I'm trying to copy is just shapes. If you see the lid area, is something like this. Okay, and that's what I'm trying to erase. Now I'm gonna use again the white charcoal and let's draw a little bit. See the nose, the eyes, nose, the chin. Okay, let me see. Stepping back. I'm measuring, okay, from the brow to the nose and the chin. I'm measuring here in the image. Okay, I think that's okay. Let's see, from the bottom of the nose to the bottom of the chin, the bottom of the mouth, usually in the middle. I think this is right. Hello, Barb Olson. Do you still have the angel painting you did? Angel painting. It was a drawing. Angel drawing. Yeah, 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 I have it. Yes, it is for sale. Yeah. And I'm gonna give you my email. Okay. I think this is gonna be easier for us to communicate by email. That's my email, Barb Olson. You can send me a message, okay? Now I'm erasing to get the shapes, and I continue drawing with the white charcoal. Okay, I'm gonna use the synthetic brush. I need to step back. I'm squinting down my eyes. I'm squinting down my eyes, and I'm trying to copy this shape, okay? Like a shape, like this is something just flat. Now I see this shape. I see how tilted this is, to the left, to the right. I try to measure the width and the height of the shape. That helps me with the likeness. Okay, not so sure about the contour of the face. I'm just gonna leave it blurry. And as soon as I get more here, I'm going to define the contour of the face. Okay, I'm stepping back, I'm squinting down my eyes, and again I'm comparing just shapes, okay? Of course, I'm always checking out the measurements, remember from the brow, to the bottom of the nose, to the bottom of the chin, same measure, okay? We're gonna split the whole face in three portions, one, two, and three. This one is from the hairline to the the brows. Hello, team. Thank you. Thank you, Barb. Step back. I'm squinting down my eyes. This is important for the likeness, okay? Getting the shape of the light, this light, the reflected light, and the shape of the shadow is, let's say, one step to get the proportions and the likeness, okay? But I gotta be checking all the time, again and again. I gotta be checking out the lightening of the eyes, the center line of the face. The line for the eyes and the line for the mouth are parallel to each other. Usually, I mean, not always. And that's something that I can just check again and again. Another thing I can check is our alignments. For example, let's say from the corner of the mouth, but it's around here, I can trace a line up and see what is aligned with the tear duct, the corner of the eye, the iris, You gotta do that on the picture, and then do that on the drawing. Okay, in this way I can correct, maybe make the mouth smaller or bigger. And I continue measuring, checking out alignments, and working on the on the shadows. Okay, because it's about making everything darker and darker, to the point that I can see some areas, like here, let's say, like a highlight. As soon as I see this area here as a highlight, that means that I'm getting close to the value, okay? The values. You know how dark or how light are the shadows. Again, I'm gonna check out again. This I'm gonna measure from the eyes to the nose to the chin. I'm squinting down my eyes. Okay, one thing about the shadows that I just love to do is just, let's say, concentrate the contrast in one area, not all over the face. I mean, I see the image and I see, oh, this is dark. I see this really black here on the brow, really black on the eye, black on the nostril, black on the mouth, black is just completely black. Now what I'm going to do is just keep some black areas just in, usually I love to do this in the eye. In this way I'm gonna make a difference in values. This is gonna be darker. And this one is not going to be as dark as this. That means that it's one way to drive the attention to that area, or to create a focal point. It's usually on the eyes, because the eyes just is a focal point. If we don't do anything, the eyes are always going to be a focal point. But if we add that, we can create some kind of, let's say, the illusion of air around the face, some atmosphere. Yeah, that's what I want to do. Sometimes, I mean, it's not like, sometimes I just want to copy the picture just the way it is. That means I'm going to go really black in some areas, or crispy black, just like the picture. But like I said, it depends, okay? It depends what we want. Just at the moment, I don't like this. I'm gonna change. Just give me a second. I'm gonna use another lid. Okay, what about this one? Okay, I think this one is better. Hello, Nikki, how are you? Okay, that's good, Nikki. Oh, you enjoyed the wet charcoal. Yeah, that was really fun. Ten Tom's asking me which paper is good for charcoal. Okay, any paper, it's any paper, just like a thick paper, like maybe in grams, is 150 grams. That's okay. You use anything like thinner, like the paper that we use for to print out documents, that's gonna be too thin. Okay, and the paper that I'm using for my charcoal drawings, it's just from a drawing sketchbook that I bought in a regular store. I mean, I didn't even went to buy that sketchbook or an art store. It cost me around $3. It was 150 grams. Okay. No, I mean, there are a lot of papers for me. I just love that this doesn't have any tooth. There are papers that have a lot of tooth, like watercolor papers. Maybe just about what you like. Speaking about what is better for the drawing, it's just a thick paper. Any thick paper. Back. Okay, I need to step back. I don't see too much yet. I mean, I don't see the likeness, but I can tell that maybe the proportions are okay. Now, obviously, I see something is wrong with the nose. What I'm going to do, I'm going to put my own brush or pencil on top of the picture to see the angle of the nose. It looks like it's kind of straight. I'm gonna move it to my drawing. Okay. So I think that's okay. Okay, charcoal is really soft. I don't need to pressure too much with the kneaded eraser. You see? The only problem with this is I'm not gonna be able to get to the white of the paper. I mean, I'm not gonna be able to erase this to that point. I know that anyway. I love charcoal because it's just easier to get to the darks. For example, it's been like what, 24 minutes, and you see, to get to these values with graphite, that's the other option. Maybe it would be like an hour. And for me, I love I love both, eh? I'm just trying to say the pros and cons. Now that, I mean, I have the values, the darks, it's kind of easy to judge the drawing faster. I mean, what I mean the drawing is the proportions, and what we always want is the likeness, eh? Now I'm going to do this with my kneaded eraser, and I'm going to use it to, like, let's imagine that this is another pencil. Yes, Nikki. I love graphite too, but just like you say, it's time consuming. Sometimes I just, I prefer to see the face faster on my on the paper. See the nose. Thank you. Okay, this small space here is kind of difficult. I have this. Okay, I have, let's say this is kind of a triangle, and the sclera is another small triangle here. Okay. Now that's the iris. Okay. That's the sclera here. The tear duct and some reflected light. To make this darker again. I'm trying to capture here. If you see the image, you see it's kind of this shape. I mean, squinting, you squint down your eyes. Okay, and there is another shadow here. Okay, now the other eye. Okay, another thing that I do is just I don't stay too much, just in one eye. And okay, I'm gonna go back here to work this eye, and I'm gonna go back to work on this eye. Okay, that's enough. Now let's think about the nose. I think the nose should be a little bit longer, yeah? Not for sure. Now let's work on the mouth. Okay. Stepping back just to see. Okay, need to reduce here. I think that's better. Okay, I need to make this area of the upper lip to grow a little bit up. Erase here. Okay. And work on this shadow. Step back. Let me see. Yeah, I think I got the position of the eyes, the nose, and the mouth. Okay. Just the mouth. I think I should tilt the mouth a little bit like that. Down to the left. Okay, I'm gonna check out on that in a minute. I'm gonna work here on the forehead, then this area. Okay. Read the comments. Seeing shapes in geometrical shapes have really helped keep me focused. Yeah, that's right, Nikki. Hello, Dennis. Okay, Dennis. That's funny. Graphite with shine, not with not enough darkness. How do that? Okay, this is not graphite. This is charcoal. Okay, I usually use a little bit of graphite at the end. But not for the darks. Not for the darks. Usually just to even some areas. Maybe that's one of the things with graphite. If we want to get some darks, we should keep adding more and more graphite, because that thing that is shiny, let's say that it's not that dark as the graphite. It's not as dark as the graphite. I mean, we can get to really, really, really dark. Just the fact that it's shiny, just. And charcoal is opaque. Because it's opaque, it looks. And it's softer, of course. It's softer than that. than any graphite. Hello, Christine. make this a little bit darker. Like I said, I'm gonna keep a bit the darkest dark here, and I'm gonna try really hard to keep this just dark, but not as dark as this area. Okay. I mean that takes to go back and forth with values because I mean we tend to copy, yeah? And that's what is going to happen to me. I'm gonna try to copy the value here. That means that I'm gonna be trying to control it to make it some area a little bit lighter, a little bit darker. Okay, let's go darker here. It's not like by doing this, some darker areas, some lighter areas, the drawing is gonna be better. No, if I copy the picture, all the values, if I'm able to do that, the drawing is gonna be okay. It's just about what you like. For me, it's about that. I mean, concentrate contrast here, all this area, and less contrast here. Okay, something like it's just like I'm doing with what we usually do with the lights. Let's say the lightest light is gonna be here, but all the lights are just gonna be mute. For example, here I see something that's really dark, crispy black. I'm gonna try to keep it. To keep it just in this value, just like that. Okay. Here's the same. This is dark, dark. You see, it's crispy black. I'm gonna try to keep it there, just there. Maybe a little bit darker, but not too much. Okay, Dennis. Okay, let me say, I woke up and I see Porter wanted to paint for Lucy. Okay. Oh, you, Dennis telling me that I missed the angle of the eye on the left. Okay, I'm gonna check out that. Okay, I see a problem here. I think this is the angle of this shadow. Hmm. I'm gonna keep this high contrast here. Okay, less contrast down here. Now, another thing that I think I'm going to do, I'm not so sure, but let's see, maybe I'm going to soften this. Let's see. I don't know. I mean, first I thought to go really black with the background here. Now I'm thinking maybe. Okay, I have to continue drawing and see if that works. I'm gonna work on the ear a little bit. Hello, Monique. Thank you. I'm thinking right now, maybe, you know, this is the effect. I mean, this is not fully the effect, but something close. You see that the hair is kind of light. Yeah. And the idea, like I said before, is to create some atmosphere around the face. And in order to get that, I'm working with, for example, this edge is really sharp, and you see this is really this darker, and I'm creating contrast here. Okay, now it's different here, less contrast, and the edge is kind of unfocused, and in the neck is even less contrast and kind of unfocused. Okay. And that's why I don't go in really dark with this shadow. In I don't know, I mean, I would like to light up this area a little bit. But I don't know if that's gonna be okay for all. You know, I mean, one thing is about this thing about the atmosphere and contrast, edges, and some focus parts, and all of that. Another thing is the likeness. Yeah, I mean, I gotta be thinking about the likeness. And sometimes we played with this thing about changing the values. That could affect the likeness. Okay. The only thing that I didn't get is this bright. Maybe I'm not gonna be able to get it, because I mean, in order to get this really light, one thing that's gonna help is getting this dark and this even darker. But what I'm trying to do is just creating some depth in this area, and you see the ear has less contrast. I mean, of course, I need some light. The shadows in the ear are not that dark. Okay, I didn't finish the ear yet, but that's the idea. Yeah? But I still need to work a little bit on the light. Of course, I don't want these lights to be as lighter as this area, for example. I added more light there, and I'm going to soften this. Okay. I'm thinking, because I still feel that I need to work on some, for example, the mouth. Light on the nose. I need to clean out this. Okay. And maybe here too, a little bit. Okay. Now in this area, of course, this is darker. Darker. I'm pressuring a lot. Here, the tip of the nose a little bit darker, just to create contrast here and to make the nose pop forward. And less contrast on the mouth. Okay. What else? I love this effect. You see this? I'm gonna make a drawing with trying to keep this. I mean, not this one, yeah. Okay. I'm thinking right now because this is a background with just one value, and I'm really thinking maybe to let's say make here a little bit darker, this area. Let's say if that helps the drawing a little bit more. Okay, now you see a difference here. A little bit darker. Okay, I think that helps the volume, the illusion of depth. I mean, the illusion of depth is not just about making everything disappear. It's like, let's say one area is, or more, there are more contrast here, less contrast here, some sharpness here, some lost edge here. And doing that, just the idea is to get to try to get the balance. It's not easy because I gotta go back and forth making some area a little bit darker, a little bit lighter, a little bit darker, a little bit lighter. Okay. Thinking about the shadows. Not repeat the same shadows everywhere, the same intensity, the same with the lights. I mean, I think I should reduce the forehead a little bit. Oh, Monique, yes, that's right. That's what I want to create, an atmosphere. Mm-hmm. Okay, I'm not so sure about some areas. For example, here I see a mistake. Yeah, there is, it has some kind of curve here. Like that, and maybe I should reduce here the cheekbone. Thank you. That's okay. One thing, I mean, you notice that I'm keeping this a little bit lighter than the hair. And I could make this lighter just by erasing. That's a doubt that I have right now. Because I'm trying to keep the ear kind of blurry with less contrast. And if I add more contrast here, I will do it okay. If it's not okay, yeah, I don't know. This thing about create this atmosphere is just, it's gonna take a while. We gotta go back and forth, trying changing values, going darker and lighter. What is another doubt that I have is about going darker with this shadow on the forehead. I'm stepping back, I'm squinting down my eyes. I'm thinking if I go darker or not. I don't think that's gonna make better the drawing. It's not gonna fix anything, it's just about the atmosphere. Obviously, the idea is to get the likeness, everything. I don't think I get the likeness like right, but close enough, I think. Well, maybe not. I don't know. You know that when we stop working, usually the next day, we start to see more and more mistakes. Okay. I want to believe that I got at least 60-70% of the likeness. I just want to believe that.
see a problem here. I think that's better. The mouth. Okay, I think that's it, because I know I want to paint in my other channel. I need to look for the image. I need to take a rest. It's 2 p.m. here. I think I'm going to paint at 3 p.m. I need to go to eat. To be honest, I would like to spend more time here drawing this. I know there are so many things that I need to fix. I mean, as soon as I'm thinking that, I'm going to just stop. It's like I was trying to see some mistakes just pumping. For example, this little shape here. The contour shape, and all. I'm not so sure is this fully right. Okay. Oh, highlight on the eyes. Yep. For that, now I use acrylic and I use a brush, a round brush, and I'm going to add some highlights here. Sometimes I can add a touch of acrylic on a highlight, let's say on the nose, a highlight. Okay, now this time. Now that I'm zooming in, I'm starting to see that I think I could work a little bit more on the ear. Just gonna be careful not to go too dark. Okay, that's it for today. It's been an hour and a half. I think that's perfect for a practice drawing. Yeah. Oh, Dennis is telling me, where's the masculine? Do you mean the apples, Adam? Yes, you're right. Okay, I'm gonna make a little bit here. First, I'm gonna make this wrinkles, and here is. Okay, I think that works. It's a suggestion. Yeah, that's it. I gotta go. Okay, thank you so much. Take care. See you tomorrow. No, not yet. That's it. Yep, that's it. No more. Okay, maybe a little bit more here. Yep, thank you so much. Take care. Bye. Okay, bye.